let's move on to our third main topic today. And our third main topic today gets submitted to us by Muzzammil Shaik, who writes, I made a decision to stop my physical media collection of MCU movies at Phase 3's end. Now, Disney Plus released exclusive deleted scenes from Endgame that were not on Blu-ray. If only Rob just said that. On Blu-ray. With that said, to keep physical media alive, should Disney incentivize based on exclusive content that physical could provide versus Disney Plus? Thanks, and I have spoken. That's the new thing I got to get made. So listen, you raise an interesting question here, Muzzammil, because you ask, should Disney give audiences more incentive to buy physical media by putting extras and features on the physical discs that aren't available on Disney Plus, as opposed to the other way around, which seems to be the way Disney's doing it, putting all these things on as extras on the Disney Plus platform that aren't on the physical media thing? If Disney's goal was to keep physical media alive, that would be something they could do. The issue, though, here, Rob, is that I do not believe that Disney's goal is to keep physical media alive. I believe that Disney Plus, for many reasons, is the death knell of physical media. Now, look, we've all known for some time that physical media is dying. The numbers are there. That's not a matter of opinion. The numbers and statistics are there.
Precipitously dying.
Yeah, like it's just at an exponential rate. Like now you have manufacturers who aren't even making Blu-ray capable components anymore because they're just getting out of the business. The sales have declined at a neck-breaking pace. Nobody buys the stuff anymore. And Disney is not seem to care one little bit about saving it. If anything, they seem to be trying to rush its demise. Rob, you brought this up to me the other day off camera, that you felt for a number of specific reasons that allegorically Disney Plus really does map out the end. I mean, obviously, just like vinyl, it's never going to 100% disappear. Let's be clear about that. But generally speaking, as a modern driving form of media, that Disney Plus spells the end of physical media. How do you see that? And how do you feel like it spells that out?
Well, okay, first of all, we just talked about the Endgame deleted scenes. And there's not just like one deleted scene that's not on the Blu-ray. There's a lot of stuff. I was clicking around. You know, I produced a feature-length documentary on the making of Tron that Disney put out in the early aughts. I went to the Tron movie to see if it was there. It's not there. It might be there at some point. But there was a new piece about Tron where Steven Lisberger, the director, was going through the archives looking through stuff. And I'm like, wow. So all of Disney Plus now has become a search mission for me to find out, ooh, what are they putting out? And I said to myself as I watched this, you know what? With the Star Wars movies on Disney Plus in 4K and Dolby Atmos, but not available in physical media, this is a physical media killer. And for Disney, I'm thinking about all my Toy Story movies, all my classical Disney cartoons, our animation, because I bought all the feature films when they would come out, the Jubilee editions. I worked on movies like Snow White and Emperor's New Groove, and I worked on a lot of these films, and so my special features are out there, Fantasia. Even I'm like, it's time. Physical media, basically, Disney jumped into that in the late 70s. We're talking physical media has been around for 40 years. It's time. This is the future. And what's so great about Disney Plus is it's to their benefit. The more content they put out, the better off we're all going to be. Who wants to buy physical media? Even I, who's the biggest physical media buyer and lover in the world, I'm like, well, my Disney collection is now rendered obsolete. You know, I just collected all of the Marvel Cinematic Universe films in 4K. I just got them all. What do I need them for now? I guess they look cool on the shelf. I mean, now that when I have them all there, when I was looking at all the stuff for Endgame and all these special features and like scenes I didn't even know existed, it's like, well, and they're in 4K and Dolby Atmos. What do I need? And Dolby Vision. What do I need them for? I mean, really, as much as I enjoy, the reason that I will still collect physical media now, John, is if movies that are cult titles or movies that are foreign films and movies that you don't necessarily think might come to streaming, movies that I want to keep that are near and dear to me, that the only way that I'm assured of having them is to have them on physical media. But with this, with Disney Plus, they have made it a repository of an entire studio's legacy. And so what do I need to collect them for? And if they're going to put out Dumbo unmolested and say that there's culturally insensitive things that are going on in this movie because it was made 50 years ago and they did not change them, what's the point of having Disney physical media if everything is there? It's a better repository than even my own collection of physical media. Now, the difference is physical media is still better when it comes to actually there's no streaming issues, there's no lagging issues, there's lossless audio. So if you have a really great home theater system, you've got better sound. But that's all gonna, it's all gonna change and get better and better and better. I can't justify it anymore. My Disney, I'm taking out all my Disney Blu-rays and packing them up.
And here's the thing too, even before Disney came out, in the last 3 years, sales of DVDs or DVDs and Blu-rays have dropped by 50%.
And that was through 2018.
Yeah, that's just the last couple of years. And you know this, the drop-off has dropped off even more. And that was without Disney Plus. Now, somebody's out there who has Disney Plus, and by the way, there's just more of these services coming, that somebody who's never bought Endgame before now, you think they're ever going to buy Endgame Blu-ray now? There's no point.
What? No, especially, no, there really isn't. Now, I understand lossless audio, and sometimes you have lagging streaming. All of those things are going to get better over the years.
And by the way, a lot of those things don't matter to 90% of the customers, right?
That's
right. And here's the other thing. If I have my whole Blu-ray collection, that's great. Let's say I'm go visit my family, and I feel like watching, I don't know, Captain Marvel. Sorry, I left my Blu-rays back in Los Angeles. Oh, or look, let's pretend this is a phone. I don't have my phone here. But look, I got my phone. I can sit down and pop it, turn it on. Oh, look, I can just cast my phone to the TV at my parents' place and watch it big, glorious 4K if I want to, blah, blah. It's just there. Look, a lot of people to me, Rob, will make an argument, but their arguments are always why they don't want physical media to go away.
Right.
But nobody's argument ever goes towards or goes against the basic position that it is going away. It just is. More and more people are going to stop buying Blu-rays. I mean, we're seeing even in the big box shelves. I got a friend of mine who's an assistant manager at one of the big box stores, and they're saying they're continuously dedicating less and less floor space to physical media now. Less and less people are buying it. It's just going away. And now that we got something like Disney Plus, where it's like everything's just there. Everything's just there. And I can watch it anywhere I want. Now, some people, this comes up all the time. Some people will say to me, well, yeah, but if what happens if Disney goes out of business? Okay, in what universe? But fine, let's play that game. What happens if they have a service outage? Well, okay, what if you want to watch a movie and you're not at home with your 5 bookcases of DVDs?
Right.
And by the way, I will always say this. Rob, I know you have talked to me yourself. There are DVDs and Blu-rays you've had that you don't have anymore. I've owned plenty of DVDs and Blu-rays that I simply don't know where they are anymore. But guess what? Every single thing I've bought digitally, I know exactly where it is and I could watch it at any time. So, I mean, it's just, there's so many advantages, and it's just, it whether or not it should go away or shouldn't, that's a separate issue. But the bottom line here, Rob, it is going away and we just got to accept it at this point.
You know, and everybody, you're talking about these what if scenarios. Mm. I was looking at Disney Plus exists now. In the last 2 days, I've been joking. I've been in an existential crisis. What am I going to do with my Blu-rays? I mean, I still have 100 Laserdiscs, John. I haven't played them in 20 years. I still have them. I mean, there's Laserdisc groups. I feel like donating them. Whoever wants my Laserdiscs, I only want to keep like 5 for whatever purpose. But I mean, Disney Plus, it's just fun to have. You turn it on. I was enjoying the color of it all, the zipping around. You know what? I just watched the beginning of, I love the beginning of Rogue One, where Krennic shows up to talk to Mads Mikkelsen. I just like, I know Rogue One was on Netflix and all that, but the way you could just zip so quickly between, I just, I got 5 minutes to kill. You know, I was going to take a shower, but Elizabeth's in the shower, and I'll just watch the beginning. You could do that on Netflix, but the navigation around Disney Plus is so quick and so easy, and it's like, yes, I've got this beautiful, beautiful Rogue One special edition on physical media. When was the last time I opened it? I mean, I can watch it, you know, hey.
Here's a question I have for you. Now that Disney is trying to push, so getting back to the original questions, like should they incentivize people to buy physical media, I'm actually of the position that Disney's actually doing completely the opposite. They and all the other studios have been trying to wean people off of physical media for a while because they know what's coming. Rob, let me ask you this, especially now that they've got Disney Plus and they want everybody to sign for Disney Plus, over or under 2 years from today, that Disney just stops putting out their movies on physical media? Over under 2 years?
I think it's over 2 years, but make no mistake, it's coming. It might be 2 years. I mean, I wouldn't have thought that for sure until I saw Disney Plus. Now, there's a lot of people in rural areas across the world that can't get Disney product. There's people right. that are still running DVDs.
Hell,
there
are people in Europe that can't get it right now.
Right, exactly. I mean, there's people so... But I have to tell you, John, there's manufacturing costs, there's packaging costs. What people don't understand is Disney Plus has just eliminated so the costs of making physical media, manufacturing physical media, shipping physical media, all of that just went away.
And by the way, and then once they print it, manufacture it, wrap it, package it, ship it, then they got to split whatever the people pay for it with Walmart that was selling it.
Right.
Or with Target that's selling it. It's just, I'm with you. I actually would guess more than 2 years, but it ain't going to be four. It ain't going to be four no. years. But no. I'll take over 2 years before
but
they stop
also,
making it.
You know, what people don't understand is physical media is already dead. It's you can still get it, and we live in a world where, yeah, I like collecting. I like collecting. I like getting discs with O-rings and little booklets inside, but that's a vestige of 39 years ago when I first started collecting physical media. And, you know, you and I have talked about this, and you're gone from physical media a long time ago.
Long time ago, yeah.
But when I look at this and I see what's really interesting is another thing people don't understand is Disney's built this platform. It's not like they have to maintain it, yes, but they've already built it. They've already, now what they're doing is it's found money. They have to maintain the servers and of course, and make sure the pipelines are all working. But basically all the heavy lifting is done. They just have to add things to it as they come in. There's barely, I mean, the costs are negligible. I say negligible as opposed to manufacturing and shipping. And look at how many things that they eliminated right away. And they've already built this platform that they're just going to get money coming in. I prepaid for a year. You know, I don't have Verizon, so I didn't get a free year. I prepaid for a year. Disney, they're just going to have money rolling in on a global scale. And the money they have to they put out is very little. Once you've built the platform.
Question here is, guys, what do you think about all this? Do you think that Disney Plus and the coming services like it, like HBO Max and everything, do you think this pretty much puts the nail in it? This is the end for physical media. Now it's just waiting by its deathbed as it fades away at this point. Or do you think there could be a resurgence? What do you guys think about that? Jump down in the comment section below and let us know your thoughts. All right.